पड़ेगा अभी. एनिलिन, दिस इज एनिलिन, नो दिस इज एनिलिन राइट. सॉरी. नाउ विच इज द ऑर्थो पोजिशन हियर? वॉट डू मीन बाई ऑर्थो एंड पैरा? दिस इज ऑर्थो एंड पैरा पोजिशन. सो दिस इज एनिलिन. सो द एडजेसेंट पोजिशन आर ऑर्थो, दिस इज योर मेटा एंड पैरा. यस और नो? ओके. सो वॉट डू यू मीन बाई ऑर्थो नाइट्रो एनिलिन, पैरा नाइट्रो एनिलिन? एट ऑर्थो पोजिशन देर विल बी एन एनओ टू ग्रुप, एट पैरा पोजिशन देर विल बी एन एनओ टू ग्रुप. सो वी कैन सिंथेसाइज ऑर्थो नाइट्रो एनिलिन एंड पैरा नाइट्रो एनिलिन. ओके. नाउ सी द सिंथेसिस, दिस इज अ मल्टी स्टेप सिंथेसिस. सो वॉट वी डू इज, कैन यू टेल मी विच रिएजेंट इज दिस? एनी वन? और जस्ट लुक एट द रिएक्शन. वॉट इज दिस रिएक्शन? वॉट इज दिस रिएक्शन? एच is substituted by COCH3 group, right? What is this reaction? Can anyone tell me? Acetylation. Yes, this is your acetylation. So what are we first carrying out? Acetylation. So what is the acetylating agent that we have used over here? This is acetic anhydride. Getting it? Acetic anhydride. Fine. So this group gets attached and this whole thing is removed as acetic acid. So first understand acetylation. When you do acetylation, this step is nitration. Which is this step? Nitration. Yes or no? Okay. So on nitration, what are you going to get? On nitration, nitro group will be attached to ortho position or to para position. Getting it? Ortho position or to para position. So you get two products over here. One is now next step is to remove the acetyl group. So we have to remove this acetyl group from here. So how is it done? By hydrolysis. So your next step is hydrolysis, where we remove the acetyl group. So in both the cases we have removed this and we get nitro. Now the acetylated N, which is there, it's a bulky group, you know, so it blocks this position. So whenever you want nitroaniline in excess, or whenever you want to substitute on nitro position, on para position, we generally block this position. Okay, so that the amount of NO2 group that is going to the ortho position decreases, and then this is obtained as a major product and this is obtained as a minor product. Okay, even in the previous reactions we studied for bromination. If you want bromine exclusively at the para position, we block this position by acetylation. So acetylation is an important step when you want exclusively para nitro aniline. Okay, so out of these two, this para is a major product and the ortho nitro aniline is a minor product. Okay, so you will have to learn this reaction. Fine. Next is halobenzoic acid. Now halo here, halo stands for what? Halogen. What does that halo stands for? Halogen. Okay, so we are going to synthesize benzoic acid having a halogen on it, and what are the positions? Ortho and para positions. Okay, so see how we are going to start with. We will take what is this? Can you tell me what is the name of this compound? This is first position, this is second position. COH gets a priority. Okay, COH always gets a priority over other functional groups. So this is first and this is second. So this is 2-aminobenzoic acid. We can make orthohalobenzoic acid and parahalobenzoic acid by selecting different starting materials. Fine. So when you select 2-aminobenzoic acid, what exactly we are doing basically here is we are substituting that NH2 group by Cl group. So what type of substitution is this? Is this electrophilic substitution or nucleophilic substitution? Anyone? What do you think is this? Electrophilic or nucleophilic? What is electrophilic substitution? When we substitute something positive with positive. Nucleophilic is when, sorry, something negative is substituted with, excuse me, another negative charge, that is nucleophilic substitution. So what type of substitution do you think is this, nucleophilic or electrophilic? What is the nature of NH2 group? Is it negative or positive? Nucleophilic. Yes, NH2 minus is substituted by Cl minus. This is an example of nucleophilic substitution. If we had substituted the H attached to the benzene, then it would have become what? Electrophilic substitution. Got it? Can you identify this reagent? This is NaNO2 and HCl. This is nothing but di. Very good. Diazonium salt is formed, no? Yes, that's right. And what is the name of the reaction? Diazotization, no? What is it called? Diazotization reaction. Yes or no? Di stands for what? 2. Azo stands for what? Nitrogen. So NaNO2 and HCl is used as for diazotization. The reaction is carried out at very low temperature, 0 to 5 degrees Celsius, where your diazonium salt is formed. This is benzene diazonium chloride. Okay, this is your diazonium salt. This is your diazonium salt. Fine. And then using this, because this reaction is used a lot to substitute aniline, you know, the NH2 group is can be replaced by other groups using this diazotization reaction. Fine. And then you can, now what you have to do, you just have to bring Cl over here. So you can carry out CuCl, or you can simply use copper and HCl also. This is Sandmeyer reaction. You must have studied in your lower standards. Sandmeyer reaction. There is Gattamann reaction also. Sandmeyer you use CuCl, and in Gattamann you use copper catalyst and HCl. Okay. So you just have to learn this reaction. So have you understood this? Okay, so you may get questions that which gas, now always remember, whenever diazonium salts react with something, this gas is, this is nothing but what? Nitrogen gas. This gas is liberated. So you will come to know whether the reaction has taken place or not by bubbles. You see bubbles in the reaction, so formation of the bubbles tell you yes, our reaction is taking place. Got it? Similarly, you can also have para-chloro benzoic acid. So just change your reactant over here. Instead of ortho amino, you go for para amino benzoic acid. And same diazotization, same thing, or everything is same. So depending upon where your NH2 group is there, you will get your Cl. I hope you people have understood this. Now how the questions are asked. You may get a question like which gas is liberated. Okay, what type of substitution is this? So this is your nucleophilic substitution. Which reagents are used? So you may get question on this reagents. Okay, you will get questions on reagents. Got it? You can expect these questions, such type of questions on this synthesis. Otherwise, if it was descriptive, there would have been a direct question. How will you synthesize 2-aminobenzoic acid? Okay, how will you synthesize orthochlorobenzoic acid from 2-amino benzoic acid? You could have got a direct question. Okay, have you all understood this? Shall I move on? And now, because right now what we were doing was mostly theory. Now our organic, core organic reactions will start from the next lecture. So next lecture onwards, you will keep your notebooks and everything ready. Even for this also, we needed that. Okay. Always keep your notebook and pen ready whenever we are doing organic chemistry. Okay. Now comes preparation of alcohols. Okay. From Grignard reagent. And this reaction you have been doing since your 12th standard. Yes or no? Right? Okay. So alcohols can be prepared from aldehydes and ketones, right? by reduction. What is this reaction? Reduction. Okay, aldehydes on and ketones on reduction give alcohols. Now the reduction that is taking place can be carried out in two ways. One is direct reduction method, where you react the aldehyde and ketone with hydrogen. So it can be nascent hydrogen or it can be hydrogen gas, whatever. For that reaction, the product is different, and the other reaction is using Grignard reagent. Okay, so there are two types of reductions. Is direct reduction, where you just convert the CO into CHOH, and the other one is Grignard. So here we are going to talk about Grignard reagent. Okay, now what is the conversion in the Grignard reaction? So this is your carbonyl group. This is your Grignard reagent. Okay, now always remember Mg, it's metal, no? So it will have positive charge and rest will have negative charge. Now the Grignard reagent breaks at here, the alkyl group and the magnesium group. Okay, so this is having a partial negative charge, this is having partial positive charge. Now what you will remember is in carbonyl group, carbon is having positive and oxygen is having negative, because oxygen is more electronegative. So always remember, in reactions, minus will react with plus, plus will react with minus. Yes or no? So what are we going to do here? This R will go to, yes, this R will attack carbon. Yes or no? And this magnesium will attack the carbonyl group. Addition is taking place. Which reaction is this? The first reaction is addition reaction. So this is how you get. So the double bond breaks and the R groups comes to the carbon and oxygen goes to, sorry, magnesium halide, magnesium MgX goes to oxygen. Have you understood this first step? This is your first step, right? Okay, the next step is hydrolysis. Okay, so what is hydrolysis? You can carry out hydrolysis. Now H2O, I will write H2O as HOH. So the bond is going to break over here. Fine. Now in this, you can also identify positive and negative part. So H is my positive part, OH is my negative part. In this case, the bond breaks over here. The bond breaks over here. Okay, so Mg is positive, oxygen is negative. So from the H2O, which part is going to go to oxygen and which part will go to magnesium? Yeah, so negative to positive, positive to negative. So H will go to oxygen. Yes or no? And OH will go to magnesium and the bond is going to break over here. So this is what you get as your alcohol and this is your MgOHX. Have you all understood this? Should I show it again? Hello? Clear na? Okay. So I will go back. Because this thing you have been studying since your 12th standard. Yes or no? Okay, now before I go to this slide, okay, let's see some examples. This is also quite easy. Okay, now since you have, see, what is the conversion basically? C double bond O. C double bond O, just remember this conversion. When you are using RMgX, so there are these two reagents we use. Let's see the direct conversion. C double bond O is converted to this group. Okay, and this is from your Grignard reagent. The R group comes from your Grignard reagent. So whenever you are using Grignard reagent, always remember this conversion. So you don't even have to go through the whole mechanism. Just remember this conversion. C double bond O is getting converted to what? CO is getting converted to what? On oxygen you will get H and on C you will get R. So let's write some examples over here. Okay, now I don't expect you to write down the whole reaction. I just want the end product. Fine. So starting with formaldehyde. Formaldehyde. And I will simply write it this way. It is, let's take C2H5MgBr. And the second one is what? H2O. Can you tell me the direct product over here? Hmm? See what happens, C double bond O is getting converted to what? COH, and you get this R. R is from Grignard reagent. So whatever R is written to the Grignard on the Grignard reagent, it will go on C. So can you tell me, this is your formaldehyde part. The double bond is converted to single bond. Now tell me what is left. Come on, unmute yourself. C2H5 कहाँ पे डालूँ मैं? C2H5 वेट शुड किधर? हेलो, कार्बन पे ना? हाँ, एंड और क्या? व्हाट एल्स? हेलो हेलो, मुझे लगा मैं हो गया, लीव हो गई. हाँ, वाइट स्क्रीन गया होगा अपना. आई राइट अगेन. H2, राइट? हाँ, सो क्या है प्रोडक्ट तुम्हारा? ऑलवेज फर्स्ट राइट द इनिशियल एल्डिहाइड, एंड जो भी ग्रिगनार्ड पे है दैट यू हैव टू पुट ऑन द कार्बन, एंड दिस विल बी H. यस और नो? ओके, सो दिस वॉज अवर फॉर्मल्डिहाइड. विच अल्कोहल इज दिस? प्राइमरी, सेकेंडरी और टर्शरी? और वॉट इज दिस? वॉट इज द नेम ऑफ दिस अल्कोहल? दिस इज नथिंग. हाँ, दिस इज प्रोपेनॉल. येस, वॉट इज इट? फिनॉल नहीं है, दिस इज C2H5. नो, इट्स नॉट फिनॉल. ओके, वॉट इज इट? इज इट प्राइमरी, सेकेंडरी और टर्शरी? प्राइमरी, या प्राइमरी अल्कोहल. वॉट इज प्राइमरी अल्कोहल? ओ एच इज अटैच टू प्राइमरी कार्बन. दिस इज योर प्राइमरी कार्बन. एंड वॉट इज प्राइमरी कार्बन? कार्बन अटैच टू ओनली वन कार्बन. येस और नो? ओके, गुड. लेट्स गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट वन. वॉट इज एसिटाल्डिहाइड? वॉट इज एसिटाल्डिहाइड? टेल मी द नेम. टेल मी एसिटाल्डिहाइड. हाँ, CH3, C डबल बॉन्ड O, H. कम ऑन, कंप्लीट दिस रिएक्शन ऑल ऑफ यू. मीन वाइल आई विल राइट द नेक्स्ट रिएक्शन. कम ऑन, सेम रिएजेंट, कंप्लीट द रिएक्शन, राइट द नेम ऑल्सो. मीन वाइल आई विल राइट द थर्ड वन. ओके, फिनिश. व्हाट इज द आंसर? ओके, टू ब्यूटेनॉल. फाइन, लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द कन्वर्जन ओवर हियर. ऑन कार्बन, राइट? या सो दिस इज, यू आर सेइंग टू ब्यूटेनॉल, नो? या वन टू थ्री एंड फोर, राइट? 2-butanol. Okay, so you can also write it this way, C2H5. Not, it's not necessary that you have to write it this way. It's just for your understanding. 1, 2, 3, 4, right? 2-butanol. Okay, what is it? Primary, secondary, or tertiary? Secondary. Yes. Now come on, tell me for the third one. This is set. This is C2H5. This is OH. Yeah. What is it? Sorry. Ha. This is 2-methyl butane 2 all. Yes. Right. So this is first carbon, second carbon, third and fourth. So this becomes your substituent. So this is 2-methyl 2-butanol. Okay. Tertiary carbon, tertiary alcohol. Yes or no? Right. Yes, good. So what are we getting? Primary, secondary, tertiary. Primary alcohols you get from formaldehyde. Secondary alcohol, now if I will write a chart over here, fine. So what you, and yeah, tell me, can, how can you prepare methanol using Grignard reagent. We can't prepare. Why can't we prepare this? We cannot prepare methanol. We cannot prepare methanol. Remember this, we cannot prepare methanol because in methanol there is only one carbon. And when you take Grignard reagent, even if you take the simplest Grignard reagent, it is CH3MgBr. And if even if you take the simplest aldehyde, that is formaldehyde, this how many minimum carbons you will get in the alcohol? Two carbons. Right, but methanol has only one carbon, so we cannot prepare methanol. Yes or no? Okay, so what is the takeaway from this? That all the aldehydes, are you people writing this down? Shall I rub it? Okay, I need some space over here. So what are you can write down a chart like this. You may get quick questions in exam. Simple chart. So when you have formaldehyde, I'm only talking about reduction using Grignard reagent. So when you have formaldehyde and any Grignard reagent, you always get which alcohol? Primary alcohol. Yes or no? When you use other aldehydes, okay, any other aldehydes like CH3CHO, starting from acetaldehyde to any other aldehydes, which alcohol do you get? Secondary alcohol. And when you use ketones, this is ketone, no? So when you use ketone, what do you guess? Tertiary alcohol. Have you understood this? So this is very, very important. You may get questions in exam asking which type alcohol do you get, and you will be given such reactants. Or you may get a question, secondary alcohol is obtained from formaldehyde, this aldehyde, ketone, or some other ketone will be given. So you need to know this. Is that clear to you? And when you want to write the reaction, just remember that CO is converted to COH and R. This R is from your Grignard and that OH is from here. Fine. So even without writing the whole reaction, you can easily write the answer. Okay, have you all understood this? This is what we have just done. Formaldehyde forms primary alcohol, other aldehydes form secondary alcohols, and ketones form tertiary alcohol. Okay, I hope you people have understood this. Okay, now let's go for the last part, organolithium compounds. Organolithium means what? Lithium is attached to carbon. Carbon containing compounds are your organic compounds, right? So lithium is attached to carbon. So such type of compounds are LI are called as organolithium compounds. Okay, they contain carbon and lithium bonds. Carbon lithium bond is highly polar in nature. Fine, because metal is attached to carbon. Okay, so what is it used for? It is used for various reactions where it is used to transfer the organic group. So what it is doing, it is giving this group, it is attaching this group to other substrate. Okay, it's a carrier of that organic group. So it is used to transfer the organic group or the lithium atom to the substrates in synthetic steps. So different reactions we need to make various intermediates. So for that, these organolithium compounds are very, very useful. So see, a simple reaction is given over here. This is preparation of organolithium compounds. So this is your alkyl halide. This is your alkyl halide. Just react with lithium. LiBr will be removed and this Li will come over here. So this is called as butyl lithium. What is it called? Butyl lithium. Getting it? And how the reaction is taking place over here? See, you can carry out addition reactions. Fine. So this is where the addition will take place. This is where the addition will take place. Yes or no? Okay, and RLi. So see, the bond breaks over here, so the addition takes place at the double bond. So this is where your Li is getting added and this is where the R is getting added. So anything you can putting that alkyl group over there, it's like this. I'll just show you one more reaction. Suppose it is like this, and you have CH3Li. Can you tell me what would be the product over here? So let's see, carbon number 1, carbon number 2. Addition is taking place at the double bond. It's an addition reaction, no? So addition will take place at the double bond. Okay. Can you tell me what would be the answer over here? What should be the answer? Where will that Li go and where will that lithium go? Addition is taking place at the double bond, no? So in this case, Li can go over here, and this is the R where it will R dash, or sorry, this is CH3, or you can also get R, this is Li and this is CH3. Depending upon the stability of the carbocation and everything, you will get a major product. Okay, now you don't have to worry much about these reactions. Only one reaction is there in this, so you can simply remember what is an organometallic compound or organolithium compound. So not much is there in your syllabus regarding this. Is that clear to you?